People, how you doing? How you doing? I'm recording from this lovely bathroom. I've been on vacation 5 days, possibly six. Lost track. Doesn't matter. I've been in here. Got away from everybody. I've been in my room. I have it at 68 degrees, the temperature. I'm right in the middle of love. 3 minutes away from Hobby Lobby. 3 minutes away from Joann's. 3 minutes away from Michael's, and walking distance from Filipino food, Mexican, Italian, Greek, what's the other one? Japanese, Vietnamese. I can't show you my belly because people are going to think I'm pregnant, and I'm not. No man juice. Anyways, I've been eating my heart out. And I've been crocheting my heart out after I bought a whole bunch of yarn. So let me show you what I got. I have it all on the floor. And I also have the patterns that I used down below. This might be a little long. We're at 121. So first off, I've been working on my crochet granny square poncho. And have this beautiful Malabrigo. It's purple. It's showing up blue. I don't know why. There you go. It's a deep purple. I don't know the color. I don't have the ball band. But you all know I love Malabrigo. Speaking of fancy yarn, my winners should have received their packages yesterday according to tracking number. And everything's been received, delivered. So I'm hoping that you enjoyed your present. Please comment down below. Let me know if you liked it. I just added a couple things since I was on vacation and I had to just mail it from where I'm at. Excuse me. I have to talk fast because I need to shower and get out. So Malabrigo, basic black, and this white yarn that I bought it when I was in Solvang. It's a cream color. And there's another color. You gotta put my eyes. This is Yarn Bee. Soft and sleek. The color is purple gray. So y'all know this color, all yarn at Hobby Lobby is 30% off. So I'm gonna go back and get some more of these. This is my last one. Let me show you my poncho. These are squares. I need to make four, put them together, and then I'm gonna stitch them together with the Malabrigo because I have two of these. And this is my first square. Pretty. This is the Yolanda Soto Lopez crochet pattern. What's up, YOLO? I emailed you. I love you. Hugs and kisses. My first teacher that loves me with all her heart and soul, and I love her too. YOLO. So this is her crochet pattern. I put the link down below so y'all can go make one too. This is my second square. I'm just throwing colors together. I don't care. I like to be groovy. This is my third square. I actually haven't worked a lot on this. This is beautiful, by the way. I haven't worked a lot because this is all I've done since I've been in the hotel regarding the poncho. So I have 2.5 squares. I need to finish this one. I do 13 rounds, including one single crochet on each one. Put them together, and then if you follow the tutorial from Jada and Stitches, she'll show you how to put them together. So that's one project. So the night before I arrived, I've been watching Zines and Rogers podcast. I can't think of her first name. Y'all know Zines and Rogers podcast. I'll put the link down below. She is a designer and a YouTuber, and she made this easy crochet granny cowl. It's kind of like, y'all know what I'm saying. the wave thing, but it's only one wave because that's cool. Then when you go down in the valleys, I get fucked up. The peaks I can do, but the valleys, it's a bunch of bullshit. This is what I did using I Love This Yarn. I don't know the colors. I didn't even bring the ball band because I did it the night before. Ta-da! Me put it on you. So see, you connected at the end, which doesn't really have a bad San Andreas fall line. You put it on, and it's fucking gorgeous! Thank you, Zines and Rogers podcast. I wish I could remember your name. I'm sorry. Info down below. I've washed this already. I've worn it. It's incredible. And look, you can also wear it as a little beanie. I prefer it as a cowl. It's gorgeous. Thank you for this easy pattern. It took about 2 hours, I'd say. I did an I hook on this. So I went down to an H hook and I did another one. But first, I stopped at Hobby Lobby and they got this yarn. Y'all have seen this. It's kind of prickly. I only bought one. This is all I have left. I use an H hook. I made another one. This is variegated yarn, so you don't have to change colors. This one I had to change colors and weave in ends and yada 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 yada. Y'all know how much we love sewing in ends, because I know the fuck I don't. I hear you, Yolanda. I hear you, everybody. I outlined it in Malabrigo. Two rows of single crochet, top and bottom. Now, this is the front. The back where you stitch it together, I must have missed a stitch or something because I have like a boobie popped out. It looks like a peepee. I don't know what's going on there. This thing, I don't know. See, it don't look bad like this, but I must have missed a stitch or something. Maybe it needs to be blocked. I don't know. I'm eating hair. But anyways, that's the back. This is the front. That's all that matters. And it fits. It hasn't been washed, but it's fine. Oh my gosh, I'm eating fiber. This is a little prickly. This is Hobby Lobby yarn. I like the colors. I love the colors, but it's a little prickly. So, same thing, little beanie. It's beautiful, yeah? Love it. So I'm at Michael's now. They're having a grip load of coupons. There's a new impeccable. I don't know if y'all have it. It's called Falling Leaves. That's gorgeous. Falling Leaves. Impeccable. It's on sale. $1.74 a ball. So I bought that one. I bought three of those and three of these. This one is called Rose Fog. Oh crap. Got the wrong one. Motherforker. Okay. I didn't. This is called Rose Fog. Pinks, creams. It's gorgeous. $1.74. Get you some. $1.74. Look at these colors. Look at these colors. Okay. Then I saw this one. Pixie Bloom Variegated. And I was like, whoa. Slow down. We're buying this one. So I got three of each. And I was just dying to make a granny cowl with this. Wonder what it would look like. I don't know if I use an H or an I, but I believe The yarn is too thick for that. It was so stiff. So let me show you what I made. I made a granny cowl. Beautiful, yeah? No border. Same thing. Zines and Rogers. Here's the San Andreas Fault. Where is it? There it is. You can see it if you look at it this way. See the line? But because it's variegated, you can't tell. It smells so good. Ta-da! I know I'm not wearing the proper outfit. I don't care. I'm just showing y'all. Y'all are fine, right? Yes. Ow. There we are again. So we finished that one. Then I went back to Hobby Lobby. And I bought, I love this carton, cotton, because it's all on sale, 30% off. It's like a mint green. And I bought this scrubby one, put it together. And I looked up dishcloth and I found Mama in a Stitch. And I made her pattern. Like I said, all the links that I use, all the tutorial are down below. Whoop-shoo. Mama in a Stitch. And I did one single crochet all around. Washcloth, face cloth, whatever y'all want to call it. You see the nubs? And the back is flat. It's beautiful. Beautiful. There's not much stretch. Oh, this way there is, but not this way. I love it. Simple. Gorgeous. So, while I was at Hobby Lobby, I found this yarn, which I lost the ball band already, because I want to make a granny cowl in this color. I know it's similar to the red one I made, but I want it, and I want it now. That's Veruca Salt. Y'all watch Fiber Spider? I put his link down below. He has his easiest tutorials. How to make this and that and this and that. And I had some red heart. So I know it's not the holiday anymore, but I don't care. I wanted to try it. Simple project, probably took 20 minutes. Whoopsh! Oh, Christmas tree. Oh, Christmas tree. Oh, Christmas tree. Simple. It's like a granny square. Double crochet. Love it. Thank you, Fiber Spider. Thank you very much. Then, oh, I'm gonna take my hair down. I got my braids on because I was napping. Ow! Well, I was asleep, not napping. It's early. Makiko and Kat from the Little Knittery, where I deliver mail, they have shown me how to make a knitted beanie. I don't know that front post, back post thing, brim stuff. I just know knit. I don't know how to purl, knit, whatever. So I brought that because I was almost done. And I finished it watching Death Row Chronicles. Ooh, that was a good show. BET, Death Row Chronicles. I watched all three parts. And I made a beanie. I made it a little longer for my son. He has a really big head. This has a minor San Andreas fault, which I don't like. Right there where the connection happened. I don't like it because I dropped a stitch somewhere here. Not dropped, but I missed a stitch right there. But you can't tell because that'll be in the back. But it fits perfectly. It's so freaking toasty. The top, I just cinched it up like a drawstring and pulled it. It's beautiful. It's so toasty. Oh my gosh, look, I'll even put San Andreas side. See, you can kind of tell right here. But you know why this happens? Because of the dang stitch marker. I have to pull it off and it was messing with me. So I'm just gonna use a stitch marker as the part that hangs. This little part, which I thought I cut off, I gotta cut off more. I weaved in all my ends too, except for the poncho, because I'm not done. But this is the beanie. Stitch markers. Hobby Lobby has these on sale for 75 cents. The Joker. Do you see that? Ay, ay. Isn't that focusing? I'm sorry, but it's the Joker. 75 cents. I bought six of them because I wanted to work on the blur. I didn't get to work on the blur. What's left? Oh, that yarn that I sent out to my winners, Miss Melanie and Miss Wanda. I made a pussy hat project with the stitch that OVW. Hi, Ovi. She has a stitch for an easy textured headband. And I use that stitch to make a pussy hat. And here it is. I made one long piece, folded it in half, and then just sewed up the sides. Gorgeous. Gorgeous. I like this pattern most of all. Fits perfectly. There's my pussy hat. I love it. I love it. I love it. I was busy, wasn't I? These were mostly done all in the first 3 days. Everything I just shown you, except for the blue granny cowl. So last night, is that it? Last night I was watching. Proper Pineapple. Her link is down below as well. And she has a thing for a boomerang shawl. I never made a boomerang shawl, but I want one. And she says she did it in one afternoon. And I was like, I have one afternoon left because I check out today. Let's give it a try, shall we? So when I was at Hobby Lobby the second time, I happened to pick up this Aurora Borealis in these colors. I bought three. This is all I have left of, woo, of the third one. It is called Tuscan Sunset. 174 yards. I bought three. That's all I have left. Boomerang shawl is complete. I was hoping to do 120 stitches across, but I only went to, I think, 90 because the yarn is quite thick. It's not fingering, it's like a worsted. And it's kind of thick and heavy. So, y'all ready? My first knitted shawl. See if I can get back. Get back to where you once belong. Get back! Get back! All it is woven in, Big Daddy. I started this yesterday afternoon and I finished it today. I use an eye hook, double crochet. If you're a beginner crocheter, you've never crocheted any big project and you're scared and you don't know how you're gonna do it, Proper Pineapple, boomerang shawl. Boom, you got it. Oh my gosh. It's just double crochet, Big Daddy. That's it. Back and forth, back and forth. You start at the bottom over here. Double crochet, you put a stitch marker where you're going to chain the three, and then boom. And you just go back and forth, back and forth. I was scared. I was intimidated by these shawls. I'm like, I can never do that shit. Are you crazy? I'll be fucking going crazy doing trying to do this. Oh my God. It is one afternoon. You know, I started yesterday afternoon, but I stopped because where I'm located, there is a all-you-can-eat lobster buffet. And, you know, Big Daddy, I love me some lobster. So I put down about 6 plates. Yeah. I ate because that's what I'm here for, to enjoy myself and relax and forget about the bullshit at home. Because there's way too much over there. I want to have my mind clear. I want to focus and create because I can't do that when I'm stressed out. So look, let's try it on, shall we? It's kind of heavy because, like I said, it's. Oh, how do you put it on? Is it like this? Ow. Oh, yeah, Big Daddy. Boomerang shawl. Bam. Who could ask for anything more? I'm so excited. It's longer than my wingspan. I don't know how long that is. I did not measure it. Okay, my whip. Oh, here's the Malabrigo I used for that colorful shawl. Hear that? They're cleaning upstairs. I need to get ready to go. I don't know what color it is. I don't know where the ball band is, but I found it. I bought this at Stitches. Let's see how much I got left. I haven't really worked on this either. This is the Down the Rabbit Hole shawl. Oh, is this the ball band for the Malabrigo? Oh shit, it's Madeline Tosh! Get the fuck out of here. Ay, ay, ay! Madeline Tosh. The color is asphalt. Yay! So, this is Down the Rabbit Hole shawl. Haven't worked on it and I'm sad. Come on, people. Mother. Porker. See? I'll be done. Colors are gorgeous. I bought blocking matte thing. Just pretend it's on. Isn't that pretty? It smells so good. We had 22 minutes. Good Lord. It's beautiful. I gotta keep going. Here's the yarn again in case y'all forgot. I bought it at Stitches. It's Dragonfly Fibers. It's called Damsel. Have a beautiful heart stitch marker that one of you guys sent me. Thank you very much. And that's it. I was a busy little bee, wasn't I? That's what happens when I don't have no stress, no drama, no noise bothering me. Just sit here, focus, crochet, crochet, crochet. I go back to work next week. I know it's not going to be like this, but I really released everything that I had, that I wanted to do, I wanted to try. I said, fuck it, and I did it. Because you don't know until you try. I'm very proud of my boomerang shawl. I'm very proud of my knitted beanie. Those are the two that I'm very most proud of. Next for the big project is going to be the blur. Haven't started it yet, I promise. But I'm probably not going to get a chance to work on it. And I probably won't be done. Not in 1 month, maybe a few months. But it's okay. It'll be my work in progress. What does Erin say? My retirement project. So I hope everybody's having a lovely, lovely, whatever day today is. Enjoy. Have a beautiful, beautiful day, beautiful week, beautiful weekend. And I hope you enjoy my projects. Yay! Bye. Peace out.